mean, let's start with session. I mean, the first session of the first DrupalCamp Bangalore. So, welcome everyone. And let's start with, about me, myself, Mohit, Aghera. And I'm working as a Drupal developer since last 2 years with Excellent. And you can find me on Drupal.org. Mohit Aghera is my Drupal.org ID. And my Twitter and my apps and links are Mohit_. So, you can reach me. Now let's start with a topic first. So now, as we all aware that Migrate and related modules are both into Drupal core now. Like if you see initially in Drupal 7, there were separate modules for migration. Migrate module that provides the basic framework for migration, and Migrate D2D, there is another module that provides to Drupal to Drupal data migration. Now in Drupal 8, both are moved into Drupal core, and both are completely rewritten and with extended scope actually. If you see Drupal 8, you can migrate configuration and content core. So its scope has been extended. Now if you do git checkout of latest Drupal 8 repo, you can see in core modules. There are two modules, Migrate and Migrate Drupal. So Migrate Drupal module is using a Migrate framework basically, which is in core, and it provides the implementation of Drupal 6 to Drupal 8 and Drupal 7 to Drupal 8 migration. Now if we see the status of migration, Migrate in Drupal core. Majority of work of Drupal 6 to Drupal 8 migration has been done. Actually, there are a few issues that are still pending, which are being worked upon. And D7 to D8 migration, it's been started, and there are the good news is that we'll be reusing the majority of migration configuration from D6 to D8. Because both have same configuration concept. And there is one more change related to Migrate UI. Migrate UI is not in core actually. It has been moved into a separate module that you can download that from Drupal.org. Migrate is the maintaining the Migrate UI module actually, which is the original maintainer of Migrate module. Apart from that, there are right now, if you see, the Migrate module is the only thing in Drupal core. That still allows, the changes related to, you can say, API related changes. Recently, around 1 month ago, a few things got changed, and now, we are. Using migration templates and other things for configuration. And there are other advanced features like migrate rollback related rust command are not yet in Drupal core. And they are moved to separate module called migrate plus, which is also maintained by MyFam. Now let's start with a little bit more into migration. Now, as we know that Drupal 8 is built on pluggable architecture. So yeah, migration are also plugins actually. Plugin is the thing in Drupal, if you see, you can consider block as a plugin, build formatter. There are various plugins actually that provides actually pluggable architecture that so that you can extend a certain class with a particular interface, and you can implement your own plugins. So by this you can provide you can provide the migration for your own custom and contributed module. And because of this, you can also migrate to fields, field related settings and all the data. So, I mean, let's see now two types of migration actually. Like, as we see in Drupal, there are two types of migration. I mean, current migration and configuration migration. So, I mean, load users and all the things that comes under content migration. And if you see for a config migration, a variable migration, a field migration, entity type related migration, the formatters, field formatter, entity views, I mean entity related view settings, all the things that comes under a configuration migration.
Here you are here is the ID. Actually, this is the ID which will be mapped using the, I mean, which we have to specify it in the template file. Will map back to, I mean, each thing one by one. So this is again a simple migration template file for migrating the user. Drupal 6 is the total page. Here you can see sample like the migration tags and all of the things. Here is the migration data for the page. So here, for example, you can say incoming tag. This is a state code in Drupal 6, then that may be a Boolean in Drupal 8. For example, if it's incoming setting of tag is text, it can be a text in Drupal 8. So this is how the field are kept. Migrate plugin one by one. The first one is a get. So I mean, typically query from source, repeat copy the query to the destination. And here you have to specify the query. But I mean, if you don't specify the query, so then also it's not in case of get. So if it's simply copy, two value to pass. Apart from that, get has a, another advantage, like it supports copying as well. For example, if you want to copy pass value to bar, right? Then pass will be copied to foo, and if you want to get the value of foo, then you can get the iterate foo and then pass it in the double quote. Okay, so it will get the value from foo and it will assign it to bar. So this is how actually pass value will be assigned to bar. So now, for example, let's say one more use case, right? Foo, here is the foo, but here we have a value iterate foo. So in that case, we have to specify, delimiters, right? So we have to specify two tanks in there. So the migration script will identify the actual the source is entered into and other two are scripts.
I'm copying now, the data file is matched. Is it a string or how that is taken care of?
Okay.
The source destination is saying it's only copying.
Yeah.
The data file is maintained.
Yeah. Yeah, sir.
How the type data is a string or array of objects or how it is managed?
Yeah, actually it will be mapped using configuration.
Here, I'm showing you the migration of values only.
But if you see about the data type, actually, like if you see in a Drupal 6 field and Drupal 7, it is a configuration, right? So it should be stored in a config migration. Because right now, in Drupal 7, there was only configuration migration. Sorry, content migration. Drupal 8 has both config and content, so there will be a separate config migration that we can specify, like along with this. This is just a snippet, but if we implement a full migration file, here we can specify like what will be the destination. For example, in Drupal 7, there is one use case. Let's say if you are migrating iframe field, there is an iframe module in Drupal 6 that shows any URL to iframe. So that's a separate field, but you can migrate this into link field, right? So that you can specify it in config file, I mean YAML file, right? Okay, so this will map the configuration. And this is how, I mean, we are mapping the values actually.
Okay. Now, let's say, again, go back. If you want to do some certain processing on the incoming values, like if you want to, make it to lowercase, then you can simply define a plugin callback, and here you can specify in the callable argument the path of the function, like how it should be written and the name of the function. Okay, so typically to keep the YAML file simple, we are specifying only one argument, otherwise it will be complex to manage it, and that function will return the modified value. So itself pretty simple actually. The thing that we do in a prepare row, if you want to do some pre-processing in Drupal 7, then we can use a prepare row function and modify the source values accordingly. Now let's say plugin content. So now if you have a source database, and if you want to make a username out of first name and last name field of any database table, right? So you can use a concat plugin. What it will do, it will take two source values, it will concatenate with some values, and it will provide the concatenated values. By default, it will concatenate with dot, but here it has a facility, and you can provide your own delimiter. So if you provide a delimiter slash, then the value will be foo slash bar. Okay. Now, deep dependency, what it will do, let's say if you are writing the filter format, right? So the machine name of filter format should be unique, right? So what it will do, it will prevent the duplication, basically. First of all, let's say you are writing the name, right? And it will be passed to machine name, okay? And after that, machine name, it is any duplication, right? So, it will append underscore and then bar, right? So, it will try to prevent duplicate machine name. filter format, for example. Filter format. In Drupal, you have a filter format for filtering content, for example, full HTML. So, I mean, if it's machine learning, it's already there. And if you go to migrate, I mean, another. Right, so what this plugin will do? This plugin will see, like, if there is already existing machine learning, it will append, I mean, underscore one. For example, existing incoming value is one, value, I mean, value. Then it will append, like, full slash one, right? Full underscore one. So this is how it will try to, I mean, remove, I mean, eliminate duplicate value.
So, as per my understanding, let's say I will say one example. I have a polygon. I have a pager 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I'm migrating from Drupal 7 to Drupal 8. Now I'm writing this pager converting from Drupal 8 format of Drupal. So, it will prevent the duplication of the
same. Yeah, but let's see one thing. Like, while migrating to pager format, I mean, you have. For body, there will be a separate content migration. And while migrating the filter format, you have to write a separate YAML class, separate migrate the filter format. So, I mean, this will actually remove the duplicate. I will actually show you like half of I mean, this is one more that prevents the duplication. This is the easy place. So, what if you do, let's say you are migrating the content tags. It talks about configuration migration. And if you have text field common, right? For example, you have field first name, right? And again, if you have field first name, right? Then, what if you do, I mean, you will try to eliminate this type of if you see in a Drupal 7 migration, we can specify the default value while doing the arrow at field naming, right? Like if we write a field naming, we can specify the default value function. Okay? So this is the same thing actually. I mean, it's written in YAML syntax. The concept in Drupal 7 and Drupal 8 both remains the same. It's just a syntax actually. Let's say if you are migrating author, and if author is not present in user's migration, then it will provide a default value. And now let's say plugin extract. Like if you if you are aware that in Drupal 8, we are storing the values like language format. For example, field name, then language port, within language one, and then 0 in the value, right? So here, if you want to extract the data from different fields, then you can specify the index. If you look for some index field, then language name, and then 0, and then value. So it will return the relevant value from this field. And let's say if you want to migrate other languages, you can specify the language over here. Now, let's say in source system, somehow data is stored in a multi-dimensional layer. And you want to make it in a single layer. Because migration script will automatically understand the array.
Machine name. So what it will do,
take the source stream, it will convert to the machine name. So what it will do, take three steps actually. First of all, it will run the transaction service on the incoming stream. So other link of character, something like this. So it will be converted to English character. After that, it will run a string to lower the stream. So uppercase letters will be converted to lowercase. And after that, it will return, it will run a function that will convert a special character to underscore. So this is how the migration. This is how the destination menu will be. So when we provide the menu like this, this will be the destination menu. There is one more thing which we discussed earlier as well, that maintains the relationship among source and destination. Like as I mentioned that there are migrate tables which maps the relationship of source ID and destination migrated ID. So this is the source ID. Here you can see the plugin migration and the migration is user. So if we run incoming source ID will be checked in this migration. So if it is already migrated, then it will return the migrated value. So this is how any migrate code that will be made to
where is the relationship
incoming value is what, for example, in the source system, let's say author ID is far, right? In migrated Drupal, it is not necessary that user ID will remain file only, right? So it will be somewhere again, right? So in migrate map table, there are two columns, source ID and destination ID, right? So initially, this migration will be run. We have to specify the dependencies. So initially, user's migration will be run, right? It will migrate both the content. So the relevant dosage will be migrated over there. And after that, this will see the table of user's migration. It will check if the source value is far. So what is the migration value? Contact photo, and contact and other contact. time of month. Till time of month does not exist. And with that, what it will look, I mean, it will speak the migration of data at all.
So now, see,
I have one table. I have some sort of data, ID, passname, email, password, and groups. So I'll be migrating data, this data to Drupal 8. So the Drupal 8 users and driven Drupal 8 are also be created. Okay. Actually, I have modified the migrate example module. It was not much stable with the Drupal beta 12. So again, I have modified this to make it work with the latest beta 12.
So here, we don't have any code. We don't have any account. Here is the migration command. Migrate
manifest. Manifesto YAML will contain the old IDs for migration class. Here it is described in this CD URL. Username, password, and the cost, and the
my Drupal is accessing source menu only, so I have given the Drupal name to the source menu. But you can specify your own source menu. You need for data accessing another source menu. I mean, you can specify your own source menu.
Roles are, users are created here, and the relevant roles are also there. Okay. And if you see role page, roles are also created, and relevant to that, data are also being attached to a particular user. Okay. So, you can create that in the market example module. I will update the page tomorrow, tomorrow and fourth day. So, you'll be able to run with the latest Google and beta 12. So probably I think for 29th, we will get another beta release, beta 30. So I'll have to modify this script for this as well. Because migrate module is the only thing still changing its aspect for implementation. Other APIs are quite stable in Drupal 8, but migrate module is changing. So it requires things. So, any questions?
I have a doubt about the question. You talk about the process plugins. So, so the plugin is like a module which you download. What is the plugin?
Plugin actually is a really simple identifier only, for example. But Drupal 8 is an entire multiple architecture. Something provides plugins. Plugin actually provides some practical architecture. For example, if you say in Drupal 8, everything is, for example, Flow is a plugin. So, what if you do? Let me give you an example related to plugins.
They are saying that module and plugin are same.
No,
like module is
not same. No, they are different. Plugin is a simple PHP file.
Yeah,
yeah. It's a simple PHP file that implements certain interfaces. For example, if you are implementing the Go, then Go related plugin will implement Go related interfaces. If you are migrating your field for migrating,
that is a base class. Is you can explain the functionality for other classes.
So that is
still module is existing the
same. Yeah, module is through a helping so plugin as well.
You know that is
see here, it's a so this is this provides actually block the hook module. It's a block. So this is a actually plugin that extends the block. Because it's a block plugin, so it will extend the block based class. Okay. And this will increment the relevant methods.
So you can see here, it's a create, delete, and all things.
So there can be entire sessions of bugging. So I mean, I'll explain it quickly. So I mean, there are lots of this is for the blog plugin actually. I mean, this is blog, so it will extend. I mean, it will extend blog this class. So I mean, you can let us relate to blog only. Okay. So I mean, blog is a test and extending web destination. Blog comment, blog submit, right? So in this field, actually, blog page will implement all the methods of blog build. But we don't build that build method right for data or all, because all blog will contain different data. It can contain a same settings, I mean for other things, but build will contain, build will get the data. So we have to implement that. And if you see, I mean, in 2007, you have to specify a few books, something like that.
I mean,
my